Good morning, dear students. Hope you all are fine and taking care of yourself as well as your parents too. I hope you all are watching these videos sincerely and regularly so that you can learn more and can get benefited more from these videos. So in our previous chapter, we have already learned about nouns, and now we are going to start with our fifth chapter of grammar, that is number. So this is our fifth chapter of grammar, number. So what is number? So number is that property of noun that distinguish one object from more than one. So this is called number. So there are two kinds of numbers. One is singular number. And the other is plural number. So, what is singular number? The noun that denotes one person, animal or thing is said to be singular number. So, here are the examples of singular number. So, just like I am writing here, army. Horse, leaf, and tooth. So all these are the examples of singular number. Now next is plural number. So what is plural number? So the noun that denotes more than one person, animal or thing is said to be plural numbers. So now I am giving you the examples of plural noun. So here, army, the plural of army is armies. Horse, the plural of horse is horses. Leaf, the plural of leaf is leaves. Tooth, the plural of tooth is teeth. So just now I told you that number, there are two kinds of number. One is singular number and the other is plural number. After that I have given you the examples of singular number, and then the same examples I converted into plural number. So there are so many rules to convert the singular number into plural numbers. So I will explain all these rules one by one. So now I am just going to start with the first rule of converting the noun from singular to plural number. So now here I am just going to write the first rule here. So rule one is, by adding s to the singular number, we can convert it into plural number. So this is our rule one. By adding s in singular number, we can convert into plural number. Okay, so here s, it gives us the sound of s or z, just like place, places, girl, girls. So here we are getting the sound of s or z from this s. So here again, this rule, it is again divided into two. So the two rules here are the rule A, that most of the nouns, it converts, we simply add s to convert it into plurals. Just like I have given an example, like place, places can be converted, place can be converted into plural by adding simply s, places, In the same way, here we can take one more example, road. Road can be converted into plural by adding simply s, roads. So here in this way, by adding simply s, we can convert the singular nouns into plurals. So this is our rule A of by adding s, converting the noun from singular to plural. Now rule B. So in this rule, when the singular ends with the sound made by the letters P and the sound is P, like I am writing here the example tap. When it ends with letter T, example Z. When it ends with K, example we can write here book. When it ends with th and gives the sound th, like path. As well as when it ends with se and gives the sound z, like excuse. So in all these conditions, we simply add s to convert it into plurals. So I told you, when it gives the sound of, when we the it ends with p and gives the sound of p, like tap. When it ends with t and gives the sound of t, like jet. When it ends with k and gives the sound of k, like book. When it ends with th and gives the sound of th, like path. And when it ends with se and gives the sound of z, like excuse. So now we will convert it into plural. So tap, the singular, the plural of tap is taps. The plural of jet is jets. The plural of book is books. And the plural of path is paths. Plural of excuse is excuses. So this is our first rule. Now we'll start with our second rule. So now the second rule is by adding es to the singular number. So by adding es to the singular number. So here es, it gives us the sound of s. Just like I am giving you the examples here. Bus, buses, pass, passes, bush, bushes. So all these are the examples where it, the es is giving the sound of s. So here the rule is, when a singular number ends with the sound made by the letters s and gives us the sound of s, like pass. Ends with z and gives us the sound of z, like blitz. Ends with sh and gives us the sound of sh, like bush. Ends with ch and gives us the sound of ch, like match. And ends with ge and gives us the sound of j, like page. So in all these conditions, in all these cases, we add es to change it into plural. Like pass will become passes. Blitz will change into blitzes. Bush will change into bushes. Match will change into matches. And the plural of page is pages. So all these are the plurals of these singular. By adding es, we have converted it into plurals. So here one important thing is that in some cases singular noun ending with s or z, so before adding es you have to double the s or z before you add es into the singular number. Just like I am giving you examples here, like if I am writing here gas, it is ending with s, so when I convert it into plural I will have to double the s here. The plural of gas is gases. In the same way, if I write here quiz ending with z, now again I have to double the z here to convert it into plural before adding es. So here I will write quizzes. Understood this? That there are some nouns, or you can say there are some singular numbers which while converting it into plural we have to add with double, we have to double s, double the s or z before converting into plural by adding es. Okay, it is clear. So I have explained two rules today, and tomorrow I am going to explain the next rules. So for till then, it's enough for today. So have a good day, and thank you.